Howdy y'all, and welcome back to the Willow Tree Farm. Better get in with it. Get on with it. We're gonna get to work. That's what I'm trying to say, man. I've been trying. Alright, today, I was gonna say I need to try to decide what we're doing, but today, I mean, there's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. I already know what we need to do. We got three fields that need to be planted. And one field that still needs to be fertilized. The field we plowed still needs to be fertilized. We should be able to park this here. Let's see. We can grab this. And then hook up the fertilizer spreader to it. And then go fertilize the field. Go fertilize the field we just plowed. And then what I want to do is take that cedar down to the bank, or down to the store, see what I can trade, how much I can get for it, trading it in for a new cedar. I'll have to take the Sammy, because the Sammy's the only one that can actually like pull the bigger cedar that I'm wanting to get. But this is already full, so we should be able to do the whole field, I would assume, this one on this one go, because the field's not real big. It's bigger than any, it's the biggest field we have at the moment as far as crops go. It's the biggest field we have. And it looks like the mud actually refreshes itself when you restart the map, so that's good to know. I was kind of wondering about that the other day, but it's good to know how it works. Does that not work? Is there PTO on this? There is. Oops. My bad. Alright, let's get her going. That is fertilizing, right? Yeah, okay. We are fertilizing. And I was going to say, it's like, I hate to drive all the way around this thing and then come to find out that for some reason the ground's already fertilized, but we need to spread it anyway. So we'll just kind of, you know, not even worry about it. We won't even worry about it. We're just going to sling this fertilizer pellets all over it. And then when we run it over, we don't need to cultivate it in, because when we run it over, the new cedar is going to have a cultivator on it. It's going to be real fancy. We're going to be moving up in the world. I know we just moved up in the world yesterday on the other farm. But moving up in the world on the cedar is very, very helpful. Especially one to one that has a cultivator. Because that's like a big thing that takes a long time, is to cultivate and seed a field. I mean, it just takes ages with like a little bitty, like 3 meter whatever cultivator. Doesn't take quite as long as plowing this whole thing, because it took me hours. I still didn't look back at the, you know, at the footage to see how long it actually took me. But it took, I'm pretty sure it took hours to plow this whole thing with that little bitty plow. But it got done. I mean, it got done. We have another arable field now. So I'm very happy we did it. I'm very happy that we did it. And I am aware of the fact that I'm wasting a little bit of fertilizer, but can't really help it. I would rather like over cover than to not cover. You know what I'm saying? To have an area without fertilizer is worse than having an area with too much fertilizer, at least in this instance. Since the field is fresh, you want to make sure to cover it really well with your fertilizer. Go ahead and swing back over here. We should be able to get a little farther over, maybe. That ought to work, I think. I'm not too worried about it. I mean, fertilizer, it's expensive to use, but it, you know, it is what it is. I could use GPS, but this tractor don't have it. As you can see, it don't have it yet. Maybe once we, you know, get a little bit more wealthier in the farming business, we'll get tractors. We'll get tractors with GPSs in them. But as of right now, this little bitty new hole, and it didn't come with a GPS. There's a little display screen down there, you know, but it tells our speed and stuff. But It didn't come with a GPS. I talked to the guy at the store, but he said these little models like this, they don't come with it. And that there's nothing he can do about it. And no matter how much I yell at him about it, he can't change it. I didn't actually yell at him. I'm a nice guy. I wouldn't yell at a salesman unless I knew he was trying to rip me off, which happens from time to time. I think we're going to drive right through these trees. That ought to work out pretty good. We'll throw a little fertilizer to them too. They might actually need it, for all we know. I know I got a tree out in front of my house that I had a lady come over from the local plant place, because it's starting to look a little shabby. And she said, oh, it's a fir tree. It's not natural to this area, so it needs a lot of water. So, in turn, I'm probably just going to chop it down with my chainsaw. That sounds a little bad, but, you know, I don't want to have to spend a whole bunch of money to keep a tree. It doesn't really make that much of a difference to me whether I keep it or not. I think I'm gonna chop it down, and I'll either chop it down, or I'll pull it out, or with a tractor or something, and then I'll just plant something different. I would consider like paying the money, paying the money for the water and the fertilizer and the fungus killer, because she said it has a fungus too. But and it would probably look good. You know, but the problem is I'm going to try to sell my house here in 5-6 years or something like that, or 10 years, whatever. I don't want it to look like crap when I go to sell it, so that's my issue. All right, let's head up, and I'll fill this up, and then I'll grab the Sammy, and we will go down and get a new cedar. This new cedar we're going to get, It should drastically improve, you know, our efficiency and all that as far as seeding goes. Let's see. I did the faster traffic things. Let's see if it worked. I think it did. They're supposed to do 30 miles an hour. It looks like they're definitely doing it. That's good, man. That's awesome. I like that. Bullet Bill. I think it was Bullet Bill that made the faster traffic thing. It's probably him. He seems like an amazing modder guy. Alright, so we need to go in here and talk to this guy and see if maybe I can work out a deal. Tell him I want to trade this little thing in. I'll set it down here so he can get a good look at it. Reception and sales office. Hello? There's not even a desk. I don't know. What in the world? That's not even right. Wait, that's the wrong one. This one. $9,000. Ugh. It was even full of seed, man. Alright, we're not gonna have enough. We need to go talk to the bank. How much is for that new... What's the catalog say? New cedar costs us $52,000. We're gonna borrow some money. Borrow. We'll borrow up to 65. How about 70? 75. I want to make sure we don't run out of money, because we got three fields of seed. So it's kind of important that we don't run out of money. Buy. Oh, look at that. That's amazing. Oh, take the parking brake off. Here we go. That is just some good looking stuff here. The Sammy should pull it. The Sammy has 100. I want to say it's 100 and something horsepower. Sammy got 190 horsepower. And this says it only requires 180. So hopefully that's the fact. I think the only issue we'll have... What was that all about? Did you see that flicker? It's like, you see what it does there? Like, when it goes down, it, like, pushes the back of the tractor up. I've had issues with that before, where the fact that it does that, it makes it hard to steer. Like, the front tires, like, the back tires go all weird and stuff, but it's actually pushing it around. I can get out of here without hitting anybody. We made it. All right. These crazy drivers on this road, man, I'm telling you. All right, so what we'll do is we're going to go fill this up with seed. And then we might want to fuel the tractor as well, because the RPMs are going to be a little high, I think. The RPMs will be high when we're seeding. So it might burn a little more fuel than normal. We'll get her done, though. Where's my seed at? I think it's in that same shed with the fertilizer in it. Can't remember where I told the guy to drop it. I think it's here. I got a hard time remembering. Yeah, it's here. Fill that up. That's going to cost us a little bit. I didn't see what we were at, but it'll cost us a little bit and we'll be alright. We'll go seed that field though. We'll probably start it out with wheat maybe? What do I got in the other fields? I got barley there. I got canola there, so I can do wheat here. Or here. I think it's there. We'll do wheat here. We got barley, canola. And then, if I can do one of these, maybe I ought to do sunflower, oat, and rye. Sunflowers is with the other seeder. So if I do oats here, and then rye over here, and then this was canola. So what if we do oats here? Because that was canola, so the rotation, since I don't have this seeder here, would bring it down to oats. So 13 will be oats. 18 will be wheat. And 7 will be rye. If we can remember that, it will be amazing. So the first thing we're going to do is rye. And I don't have my little deal. I think that's rye. Right? Is there a symbol in here? Okay, there we go. Alright, that's rye. So 7 is going to be rye. The one right here next to the big one we plowed is going to be a rye field. Whoa, what in the world? It's lag. What? No way. I'll bet I got a mod acting up. I don't know what mod it would be. I only added one today. I think it was only one. I added the bigger bale thing that just came out on FSUK. I don't know that I'll need it, and I don't really know how it works. I figured I'd get it and we'd try it out. I'll have to check my logs and see what's going on there. It should be in the logs what's happening. Because for the last several days, it's been just fine. We haven't had any trouble. I didn't put fuel in this thing. It should be fine. I think we should be alright. At least I hope so. Look how how fast that gets dirty. When it's, hopefully this Sammy can do it. If it can't do it, then I don't really know. I might have to rent a bigger tractor. I don't really want to do that, though. The Sammy, it should be able to do it. But, you know, with Farming Simulator, sometimes it's kind of a pain. It seems like it's not going to be able to do it. I know there's certain tractors you can't use this seeder with for some reason. It's kind of weird. Maybe if I lock in four-wheel drive, it'll help. Sometimes it's a little funny though. Cause like I said, that little bit, like those little wheels right behind the tractor on the cedar, they like push the tractor. And I'm getting that lag. I don't really know what that's all about, man. I don't really know. We should be able to just continue just like this, though. Eventually, we'll get it all planted. Alright, so basically, I did some poking and some prodding around just to see what was going on. You know, why I seemed to be having that problem with the, like, the glitching and the lagging or whatever it was. And from what I could find in my logs, it seems like, at least it appeared as though, the gate. I didn't actually hit the gate, but the collision on it is really, really bad. It appears as though it seemed like, from what I could see, it said something about course play and the animation map trigger. Which obviously we can't get rid of the animation map trigger because that's how you open the gates and doors and that sort of thing. I took course play out and I've been doing the whole field just to kind of see if it was going to run proper. And I haven't had any more trouble ever since I took the course play out. I was trying to do the ridge marker, but it doesn't seem to be showing up very well. So basically now I'm just kind of keeping the fender, like the outside part of my fender there for my front tire. I'm just keeping it right where, like right on the edge there. And I think it'll seem to work pretty good. This cedar though, man, it is such an upgrade. Such an upgrade from that little bitty one. I've never actually used that little bitty one too much. But, I mean, just using it the little bit I did, you know, and even using that little plow the little bit I did so far, it is such an upgrade to get like bigger machinery. The initial grind in Farming Simulator is kind of real sometimes. Kind of ridiculous. Alright, do that border, and then I should be good there. But this field shouldn't take that much longer, and then we can move on to do the other field. As long as I can remember what all we're going to put on it. I know the one field was canola already, so we should be good on that one. Field 13 was canola already. But that's just going to move down to oats. We're doing rye on this one, doing oats on 13, and then, what was it, wheat on the other one? Because there's barley on the... But then we'll have every crop in the ground at one time. So then the rotation for now should be pretty good. And my turning's a little funny still. But the Sammy seems to be doing a pretty decent job pulling it. The field's a little rough since it just got plowed, but the cultivator on the cedar is definitely like leveling it out real good. Definitely doing a good job. I will be happy when we get a bigger tractor, but like I said, the Sammy seems to be doing a pretty decent job covering it over. Pulling the cedar along. I haven't had really any issue. Maybe what we'll do is we'll kind of go down the side of the field here. So we're going to have to keep, like, trying our best not to hit the fence. I did do, like, two headlands. I kind of went back up and back a little bit. Just so I got a little bit of turnaround room and it makes me feel a little better. I'm gonna go ahead and get that. Normally I would leave it, but since this is the initial planting on this field, I don't want to leave anything. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to leave anything the initial planting. I'm trying to get all the rough spots out. That way if we get like a real nice classy tractor in here, it doesn't really have to like go through the bad stuff. I mean, it's got to drive through like a big mud hole on the way into the field, but once it gets into the field, it doesn't have to drive into furrows. But you never know. If we can get like a big like plow, whatever. Because I have this thing. It's registered as a plow. This thing. Like eventually I think we'll get that. And that basically, that disc, I mean that disc will tear up the ground just like a plow will. Eventually we want to get that. That way we can really work the soil. Especially like once we start putting manure and stuff down, manure and slurry on the ground. Mainly manure, because slurry kind of just soaks in. But once we get to the point where we're throwing a lot of manure on the ground, we'll really want that big disc. And it'll help us work the manure in real good. So I'm gonna finish this up and then I will head over to the other field. Which I might just keep recording because I kind of like the drive. And I'm assuming maybe there's other people out there that like the drive. I don't really know. I kind of like the drive. Like, you know, the non-working, you know, just kind of driving around, whatever. Drive over here just for kicks. Gonna stay to the side of the field. I know it's just seed, so you can kind of drive over it anyway, but we'll drive over here anyway. I probably should have left a little bit of space over here, a little gap for driving the tractor up and back, but we won't be driving up and down the field too awful much. Let me set my parking brake there so I can come back and close this gate, because we're done in there. We're done in there until it needs to be fertilized. And then we'll come back. Oops. My four-wheel drive button's right next to my start and stop button. The other field shouldn't take nearly as long, because they're not even half as big, I don't think. They're not big at all. 13 won't take long, and then 18 will be really fast. Because it's just a tiny little thing. The 13 is the one that was canola. I know I keep saying this, but I have to keep telling myself, otherwise I'll forget. That's wheat. I'm going to plant oats. There's some oats down in this field. I think, if I remember right, the gate's closed. I want to make sure to pay attention and not run into it. Okay, it's closed. Let me jump out and open it. It is really nice how the drive control like leaves you in the cab. I think it's the drive control doing that, isn't it? Alright, let's get this thing turned on. And then we'll take off. We will take off. Hopefully this won't take but like a couple of minutes. I just had Butcher Lady come in. She came home from work. And normally I leave my computer room. I say hello. But since I'm recording, I didn't leave my computer room and say hello. So she came in here and she's like, I'm home. I was like, I'm recording right now. So, sorry. Yeah, it don't really bother her. You know, she likes to hear a hello, I guess, when she comes home. If you're married, then you completely understand. I would assume so. Just missed the tree. That's good. That's good. Is that even getting it? I'm just like driving way up in the thing there. That didn't sound like it was even getting it back there. Try to make sure to leave a little bit of space when there's hills like that. I know the video I did, or the work on the farm yesterday on the Dilvelishvast farm or whatever. I was using that big old crone rake, and if you use that thing, and there's like any, like you drive down in a dip in the field, it'll like lift the back of the tractor up. And that did happen on my first pass. You probably can't see it in the video because the video is going really, really fast. Like 8 times or whatever. A little bit of sliding there. Thought I was caught on the gate there. Can't even see hardly. Man, I can just barely see like the change in texture. That's crazy. You can see it down there pretty good, but up here you can't hardly see it at all. Really wish I could see a little better. But this shouldn't take us very long. This should only take me like a little bit. I want to get all three of them planted today though. I am having to really, really concentrate to try to like figure out where in the world the change in texture is, where the seeding is and where it's not. I think I'm covering the whole thing right now. It's very difficult to see, though. I don't know if I've ever even seen a map like that. Where it's that difficult to actually see the texture difference. It might be the fact that my windshield's a little dirty. So, maybe, next episode, we might be able to afford to, I want to say afford, but we owe a bunch of money to the bank, but we might be able to get a pressure washer. When you owe money to the bank, you can't really say, I afford it. I can afford this. The bank can afford this, and I'll pay the bank back. But that's the life of a farmer, I guess. Sometimes you just owe the bank more than you're actually worth. And at the moment, we don't owe them a lot, but we owe more than we're worth, I think. More than we can bring in. But that's kind of like a juggling scheme when you're a farmer sometimes. You gotta juggle, you know, loans from the bank, between loans from the bank and making money. And then eventually you will get, you know, the best of both worlds, if you say it that way. You know, eventually you'll like overcome the bank, I would hope. You know, you'll pay off your bank loan and then you just start saving and buying more tractors and stuff, more land. Right now we're still a young farm. Still have a long ways to go on the equipment aspect. Let's run over here and do field 18, since we now, you know, remember that we own it. Because before I didn't realize I owned it. When I was doing the seeding, when I seeded the first field that we harvested, if I'd have known we owned this, I'd have went and like bought this already. Not bought it, but I'd have went and seeded it straight away, because this thing's super small. But even that small cedar, it would have been a pretty good job to do. And it does open into the crop section, so and it's plowed. That's good. What I might do is I might close it, and then I might seed it one line of grass. You know what I'm saying? Like on that back end, a little bit of grass. Put one grass line there. Because I really like, I don't really care much for whenever the grass, like when the gate opens up into the grass. I just don't like it. And get this positioned properly, we'll do it. I don't know. To some people that might seem like a waste of space, but we also need a place to pull the combine into. You know, at least try to pull it in without like messing anything up. Switch this over to grass. And then we'll put her in drive. And then we'll just kind of do this. I hate doing the overhead, but I want to keep it as straight as I can. So it looks at least halfway decent. I'm not going to make it there. Go ahead and turn that off, otherwise we'll end up with... let's see. Kind of want to do, like, around the fields. We'll just leave it like it is. I was going to, like, round out the edge. Oh, I did it wrong. I was going to round out the edges, but I think we'll just leave it. We'll just kind of go from there. At least help us out kind of from the gate aspect. We did already fertilize this, if I remember right. We already fertilized it, so we should be good from there. We should just be good to seed, I guess. Because I'm pretty sure I came down and spread fertilizer on it, right? I don't know. I think I did. And it is plowed, so we can actually see, you know, the change in texture really well. That's why we couldn't see it on the second, but we could see it on the first one, because the first one was plowed. But the second one wasn't. The second one was already cultivated. I'm assuming from here on out, unless we, you know, but until we get that big disc, which that big disc requires a big tractor to pull the big disc. Whoops. Helps if I don't turn around and look, I guess, while I'm going. But yeah, that big disc, it ain't all that expensive, but you need an awful big tractor. Like, we'll probably have to pull that thing with a quad track. So until we can afford a quad track, we'll be kind of stuck without that thing. Gauge the four-wheel drive. That's kind of neat that four-wheel drive actually makes a difference. It's just like a visual, you know, make you feel good sort of thing. It actually makes a difference. For the most part, I say that and then I can't hardly control the tractor. Now we should be able to just kind of swing around the end instead of trying to make some hard turn. This won't be a whole lot of crops, and you know, it may not even be that worth it to come down here to do it, like bring the harvester and the trailer and all that good stuff down here to do it, but any little bit counts at the moment. Not really sure what we're going to do tomorrow yet. It'll probably be more grass work. It'll either be more grass work, Or we may rent some forestry equipment to do a bit of forestry. Cut some trees down. Probably won't make any wood chips just yet. But we'll probably cut some trees down and sell some logs. Get our farm moving a little bit. The rental prices aren't that bad these days. It's a lot better than it used to be. You know, the rental prices kind of came down. The economy's not at the peak. At the moment, so the rental prices are a lot lower than they used to be in the old days, back a couple of years ago or something, a couple of seasons ago. All right, we should be able to open that and it won't be over the grass. There we go. That's not too bad. I think that'll definitely work out. That'll work out. And it'll look better once there's actual grass grown in there. The grass will grow at the same rate as the crop, I would assume. Do it on fast growth rate? I think we do. Yeah. All right. Add this thing back to the farm. And I won't cut that out either, because like I said, I like the driving. I like the driving portion, just to kind of, especially like with the faster traffic, it makes it more realistic, because you actually have to pull up and kind of look and wait and look, and then just kind of go for it and hope there's not a car there. Sometimes it's how it is in real life. You're kind of driving around and you'll like kind of pull up and you look, and then you're just like gun it, you know, I don't think... I can't remember if we went out and looked at, like, prices of fields and stuff yet. I think we did. But I can't remember how much they were. Even if we didn't, we might do that next time. I don't think we'll buy anything, because that would, you know, indicate that we're going to be doing some more seeding, and I don't really want to do that at the moment. But hopefully we can grow all these crops, and then after harvesting them, then we can get enough money to buy some more equipment, maybe pay a little money to the bank. We do have those silage bales that we got them yesterday, so we should be able to sell them as early as tomorrow, I think. That might be the general rule of thumb we go with, is keep them for at least 2 days. I think I like that idea. We keep silage bales for 2 days before we sell them. We'll have to keep track of, like, if we start doing more and more grass work, we'll just have to keep track of which ones are which. I'll go ahead and fill this up. But we'll have to keep track of which ones are which, unless, you know, we know we're going to sell them. We might just sell all of them straight away before we make any more, because that would make it a lot easier. I don't know what that is. Is that milk? That's not milk, because the cows are down there a bit. So I don't really know what that is. Water? Really, it wouldn't be water. That might be a water tower, like a little water tower thing. It might be spray? Like liquid fertilizer? But I would think that's what's in those things there. Maybe it's water. There's a blue pipe on it, so I'm thinking it's probably water. Just park this in our cedar spot where we had the other one. That seems to be a good spot for stuff. Get her backed in here right quick. Might just bump the back a little bit. Maybe not. Oh yeah, that fits in there real nice, doesn't it? Oh, and I just almost bumped it. Look at that pro driving. You don't even know about pro driving. Then I back into something with my pickup. And you guys are like, look at that. That's not pro driving. All right, we'll head back over to the house and we'll be done for the day. We got a lot accomplished. We fertilized, or not fertilized, we planted 3 fields. What else did we do? Was that all we did? Not all we did, but I mean, that's a good amount of work. Did we do anything else? Oh, we fertilized that field. I was going to say, it's like, I'm pretty sure we fertilized a field. But we did fertilize that field. You know? We got a good amount of work done for the day. But thanks for coming to hang out with me, guys. I hope you come back tomorrow and hang out with me some more, and then we'll do some more work on the Willow Tree Farm. Y'all come back now, you hear?